dear students, in the last video we have learned about we have started a lesson about the heat, yes or no? In that we are discussing about the temperature. What is exactly the temperature, yes or no? What is meant by the temperature? The degree of hotness and coldness is called as a temperature, and the instrument used to measure the temperature is called thermometer. Yes. Then we have learned the two different types of thermometer, that is clinical and laboratory thermometer. Am I right? Yes, we have discussed two types of thermometer, that is clinical and laboratory thermometer. Then if you will see the scale of clinical thermometer, if you have observed the thermometer properly, then there are the two scale, that is Celsius and Fahrenheit scale. So in today's video we are going to discuss about the problems on the conversion, how to convert the Celsius into Fahrenheit and Fahrenheit into Celsius. Do you remember in the class 5th we have the lesson, it was in maths, that is temperature, that we have learned in the science, and already we have learned about the conversion of a degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit and degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. You know these two formulae very well, am I right? Now it's the time to write this formulae. Now write this formulae in your notebook properly. Open your physics notebook, write this formulae properly in your notebook, because related to that we are going to solve the word problems. We are going to solve the problem. Already I have given the worksheet. Now see, this worksheet is provided to you. Remove this worksheet and write this formula in the notebook first. Then we will move to the worksheet. This worksheet you have to solve in the notebook. You have to solve in the notebook. I will wait for 2 minutes. You just bring the notebook back and this worksheet. We will move to the worksheet. I will wait for 2 minutes. So bring this worksheet and open the notebook and write down this formula properly. Write down this formula everyone. Degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit, when we are converting, then we are using the formula, that is 9/5 into Celsius plus 32. Then when you are converting degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius, then we are writing 5/9 into F, that F should be written in the bracket, minus 32. And also there is a one more scale that we have learned about, a Kelvin, that is Kelvin is the SI unit of temperature. When degree Celsius, when you are converting into Kelvin, then you have to add 273, while when you are converting the Kelvin into Celsius, you have to subtract 273. You have to subtract 273. This is minus sign. So minus 273. So write this in your notebook properly, all the formulas, because related to this we are going to solve this worksheet. I hope everyone has brought the worksheet. You have to write this worksheet in your notebook. Come on, write down this formula fast. I hope everyone has wrote this formula. Now we are going to solve this problems in your notebook. I am going to solve some problems, and the remaining problems you will solve it by yourself. Okay. Now see the first problem, question number 1. In this question number 1, you have to convert degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. Yes or no? Convert the temperature given in the Celsius scale to the Fahrenheit scale. Now first is 25 degrees Celsius. I will show you the 3 examples, and others you have to do it by yourself. Now see, 25 degrees Celsius. Now you have to use the formula degree Fahrenheit is equal equal to 9 upon 5 into the Celsius, you will write 25 plus 32. Okay, 5 5 5 5 is 25. So 9 5 is 45 plus 32. The answer will be 77 degree Fahrenheit. Are you getting? Only you have to put the value in that formula and you have to solve the problem. See one. I have shown you one. I will show you third and sixth. Now see, third one you will move. That is, third is 0. Third one is 0 degree Celsius. Am I right? So 0 degree Celsius, again you will use the formula 9 upon 5 into 0 plus 32. Now when you are multiplying any number, the answer, the product will be 0 plus 32. So answer, it will come 32 degree Fahrenheit. Are you getting? One more example, that is 6th example I will solve. That is 40.3 degree Celsius. Are you getting this? Now 40.3, already in the decimal you have learned, that is 40.3, then you can add the number of zeros after that. Am I right? The value will not change. So 9 by 5 into 40.3 plus 32. 5 1s are 5, 8s are 40. Now 0, 5 6s are 30. Am I right? 5 6s are 30. Now 9 multiplied by 8.06. 9 6s are 54. 5. Then 9 7 9 8s are 72 plus 32. Then this 0.54, it will come as it is 4 and 10. So 7 plus 3, 10. So 104.54 degree Fahrenheit when you are converting 40.3. Only you have to put in the formula and you have to solve the sum. Remaining sum you will solve it by yourself. Answer key will be provided at the end of the period. Okay, this was the first. Now we will move to the second, degree Fahrenheit 2. Now we will move to the question number 2, that is degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. Now see question number 2, that is you have to convert degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. The first example is 102 degree Fahrenheit. Now when you are converting Fahrenheit into Celsius, you have to use this formula. That is, see, you will use degree Celsius is equal to 5 by 9, opposite. 9 by 5, you have to do the reciprocal of that. 5 by 9 into this, you have to compulsory write in bracket. Degree Fahrenheit minus 32. What is it means? Means you have to first subtract this and then you will use this operation. Okay. So 5 by 9 into Fahrenheit is 102 minus 32. First you will solve of bracket. So 5 by 9 into 102 minus 32. When you will solve this, you will get 2 minus 2, 0. Then 70. Am I right? So 70. Now 9 is not divisible by 70. So if you multiply this, so 350 upon 9. Then again you have to divide it. It will come in the point. Okay? So 9 3s are 27, 9 4s are 36. So 9 3s are 27. 27 now remaining. Then you have to divide this. You will get the answer 38 is 89. Here 8 is recurring. This 8, it is recurring. I have round up this. It will come 38.8. Now 8 is there. Now you have learned the rounding of number. When it is more than 5, then you have to write here, you have to increase one number. So I have increased it. So 38.89. Are you getting this? So this will be in degree Celsius. This will be in degree Celsius. When 102, when you will convert into degree Celsius, it will be 38.89 degree Celsius. Are you getting this? Then one more example we will solve. That is third one. I will solve the one more example, third one. Other all example you have to try to solve it by yourself. That is 200 degree Fahrenheit. So again you will use the formula 5/9 into degree Fahrenheit. So again I will use directly 200 minus 32. Now 200, first you have to solve the bracket. First you will solve the bracket. So 5/9 into 168. Am I right? So 200 minus 32, it will come 168. Now you will multiply 5 in by 168. So answer will be this, it will come 840 divided by 9. Now when you will divide this, you will get the answer 93.33 degrees Celsius. Are you getting this? First you have to multiply this 5 by 5 into 168. You will get 840. See, 5 8s are 40, 4 carry 9, 5 6 are 30, 30 plus 4 34, 3 carry 5 1 are 5, 5 plus 3 8. So now when you will divide this, it will get 93.33 degree Celsius. Here 3333 it is coming, so you have to round it to the one digit or at least two digit. Are you getting this? So other example, try to solve it by yourself. This all the example, try to solve it by yourself. Only you have to put the formula in that and you have to solve the sum. Even question number 3, one day minimum temperature in Bombay was recorded as 80.6 degree Fahrenheit. Now here you have to convert into Celsius by using this formula. Okay. And the question number 4, in the month of June, on one day the maximum temperature in Delhi was recorded as 42.4 degree Celsius. You have to convert into Fahrenheit. You have to convert that particular Celsius into Fahrenheit. You have to use this formula and you have to solve the sum. Now there are some sums you can also, they will give to convert the Celsius into the Kelvin. If suppose 35 degree Kelvin is given and you have to convert into Celsius, then you have to use this formula. Okay. Likewise, the sums will be provided, given to you, and you have to, by using the formula, you have to solve the sums. Okay. And related to this, I am going to conduct the test on word problem and small test of the only on temperature, the theory part. Okay. So be ready for it. I hope you have understood it. I am going to give the answer key at the end of the period. You have to solve the sum properly in your notebook by proper state. You have to write proper states. Okay. Thank you.